J. Pancake, Pinckney Benedict, those kind of people, I think they're able to capture more the essence of it as far as its violent past and its and the mysteriousness of it and the spookiness of it. They inspire me to at least describe as little of it as I can in a poetic manner.
We are come to a world within the world. In these alien reaches, these maugre sinks and interstitial wastes that the righteous see from carriage and car and other life dreams. Ill-shapen or black or deranged, fugitive of all order, strangers in every land.
I come up here and smoke cigarettes when I'm on a motorcycle ride. Over 50 magazine. I keep all my magazines here. I just come here to read my magazines. It's a nice old chair in there. It's a nice feeling house though. I've been in other houses that just felt bad. This bad things happened.
Are you sensitive for things like that?
Yeah, can feel them. But not as Teresa one time was in this. They were in a bed and breakfast over here, and it was an old. It used to be a Civil War hospital. And you walk up these stairs to the second floor to where the restaurant is, and she walked up these stairs, and just. Froze, and her mom was like, her mom turned to her and said, "Do you see that?" And they saw all these terrible smells and just these Civil War guys that had legs amputated and stuff, and it was like a pile of amputated limbs in the corner of the porch.
And they could see that?
Yeah. And other people had seen it too, supposedly. But I've never seen anything that obvious.
Sleeping with my dreams.
if you take all the superstition and mystery out of things, they just sort of lose their specialness. We just throw a wrench in so many things, you know, if that mystery wasn't there. Or even knowledge of the human body. My friend Mary Di, who's Mary Diana, the doctor. Because she had to do, they had to do anatomy class. And when it came to time to dissect the penis, doctors in training, they just couldn't bring themselves to dissect the penis parts. She was like, oh, I'll do it. And I asked her later, you know, when she made love, did it make it any less magical now that she knows exactly how it operates or what it looks like from the inside? And she said, yeah, a little bit. So I guess sometimes it's better not to know.
Oh, God! That was a huge one!
Hey, can I see the snorkel?
Huh? It's really important for me to be able to just pee off my front porch without anyone seeing me, or make as much noise as I want and not disturb other people, especially having a recording studio. I don't even like for my wife to hear me singing. And plus, after living in New York and Los Angeles, I just had to get, you know, be away, be isolated, you know, have some open spaces.
Does that also reflect? Is that also reflected in your music?
Yeah, I think so, but not in a real conscious manner. It's not really contrived that there's that much. I mean, I've come to learn that the holes and the silent parts in music are very important. And even when we were standing around looking at that last house that we visited, there was so much going on that you just wouldn't notice, even if you were walking the sound that your shoes made on the grass. A lot of the animals, you would just never notice if you were even breathing too hard.
A horse, my kingdom for a horse. Rattling on magnetic fields. Yes, I did use up the last box of sparklers before they went bad. Got wet or decayed.
My songs, I just don't feel like they're even mine, that I'm just a conductor. Even living here, I feel like